everybody, and welcome to Dark Souls 3. This is going to be part 2 of my long play format playthrough of the game. I believe what I said I was going to do at the end of the last video was that I was going to go get the undead bone shard from the swamp so that I can get my Estus flask upgraded a little bit. But let's talk to her and see what she has to say. Now, something that you should immediately notice is just the blessing of the moon. So, also based on what she drops when she dies, I'm going to say that she was a former Darkman Blade. But, more than that, she has a quest line that ties in with the Mound Makers. And, let me check here, I do believe I picked it up. Yeah, the Dream Chaser's Ashes. I'm not going to give that to her now because I'm not entirely sure how her questline works, but I know that after she leaves here, since I exhausted her dialogue, after I give those ashes to the Handmaid, which give me nothing to buy from her because they're useless, apparently. I don't know what that deal was about. Dream Chaser, I guess, are saying it's pointless. Anyway, she will come back, and then I'll be able to begin her quest line, summoning her for boss fights and stuff. But I don't have to do any of that. All I have to do is actually go into her world and help her kill a couple select NPCs. Yeah, let's get over to the swamp, pick up the undead bone shard. Go here. That's the closest, I think. I don't know. No, it's not closest. No, not closest. I don't care. I'll run there anyway. Yeah, I apologize. In the first portion, I had some audio settings checked that, because of the nature of the headset I'm wearing, since it's so sensitive, it picks up everything, so it's constantly running. It turned the audio of the video all the way down for the entire time, which sucks. But it's fine, because I thought maybe a little bit of music would help. Anyway, yeah. This time it should be good. I tried to get a good mix. I listened to it, did a couple audio tests. I think it's okay now. Is this gonna kill me? No. Oh boy. I didn't realize that dropping down here was going to be so bad for me. I've never done that before. Guys, I don't think that's how rock works. Whatever. Did I? I didn't. Alright, so I forgot to show this covenant up here. I'll go ahead and do that while I'm thinking about it. Ow. I showed how to get up here, and I showed it, like, the area, but I didn't show exactly what was up. So yeah, this is the Covenant of the actual boss of the area. It's kind of cool. I showed this, because I was doing the playthrough again immediately after having done like 3 episodes and finding out that the footage was corrupt. I just wasn't in the proper mindset to show everything. I wasn't thinking about it. But we're all good now. So, now that we got that, if I'm thinking correctly, yeah, we have to kill the Crystal Sage, which I just killed on another character. This is, depending on the RNG, this is a pretty intense boss, I have to say. If everything goes well, it's fairly easy. If things don't go well, because I figured out that it doesn't have to engage its second phase ever, but if it wants to, it can do it almost immediately. And if it does that, then you might as well just homeward bone out, because that's not happening. And because I can't remember which recording session I actually mentioned it in, that spell that he's casting really fast like that, now that guy out there, is Farron Dart. So it's basically Soul Arrow, but you can cast it rapidly, so it of course does less damage. No spell casting for you. I love weapon arts. They're so cool. Oh, shit! That was awesome. damn it! I thought I was gonna... Whatever. I don't have time to just sit around and wait. Perfect. Now he's doing it. Of course he does it again. If I had a bow, this would be so easy. I just gotta take random guesses and hope I get it right. No, why is he over there? Come on, come on, be over here. Nope. Which one are you? Oh, he's over in the corner. No, no. Burn you! Oh, yes. Yes. Stay down. Oh. I totally expected to walk around that corner and for him to just be casting that laser. The white dragon breath or whatever. Oh. Man. Oh, I did not expect to have that much trouble with that boss. Well, let's continue on. This will have to go longer than I expected it to. Because I plan on beating the next boss in this. Who knows how many tries that'll take. Oh, there's an armor set here. I forgot to grab. Nope, stop it. I'm actually going to go back. Nope. Never mind. I'm going to go get the bonfire first. So I think I'll put all of these levels into intelligence and then go get great magic weapon and get a staff. Actually, I think I'll use that staff I picked up. Yeah, I should have enough intelligence. I think it requires 16? Maybe 15? For the spell, anyway. I'll try to get 16 intelligence, and hopefully that'll be enough to use Great Magic Weapon. Because I already have the bonfire where Great Magic Weapon is. I just need to go grab it. I don't want any of this stuff that I get from his soul, at least I don't think so. This should get me where I need to be. Do I have enough? Do I have enough to purchase this stuff? Yes, and that requires 10 intelligence, and I should have, if I remember correctly, I should have enough to use this heretic staff. What's this thing look like, anyway? It'll do. Now we will go pick up spell. This should make the next area and boss significantly easier. Or so I would like to tell myself. So, Great Magic Weapon is right down here. Not killing you. Too much health. Nah. After this, I'll go back and I'll kill the optional boss, the cursed rotted greatwood or whatever that thing's called. I think that was the name, but wouldn't be the first time that a name that I thought was correct just was poorly translated from the Japanese version and they completely changed the name for the English version. But we will see. Tune it. And grab the umbral ash from this dude. Hi, bro. Ah, that would have been a parry. That would have been a parry in Dark Souls 2. I win. Give that to the handmaid later. I shouldn't fight this guy. Not worth my time. I can't remember if there's any good drops just like sitting around here anywhere. I know that there's an Estus Flask shard up here on the left, but first we need to go straight inside, grab the bonfire. That's the trick to the dogs. Block them once, beat them to death. I forget. I remember that there's at least a couple drops around here that are worth my time, so we're just gonna explore for a sec. Because I'm pretty sure the witch tree bell vine's over here, among other things. So, let's go down. I remember I had a ton of rings on the Japanese version, and I had no idea where I got any of them. And I did come over here a couple times, so I'm thinking it has to be over here that I got some of those rings. This room still confuses me. Oh no. Infinite bleed damage. Joy. I gotta drop anything. Saint Tree instead of Witch Tree. Oh. Oh, screw you! Well, if I had a weapon that used that... Yeah, this is definitely a good direction to come. No! Can't escape. Oh, what's this? Oh, that's good. Oh, I could actually upgrade my weapon again if I went and got other materials. What's up there? I should go get that. Alright. We're gonna kill this thing. Major damage difference. I actually hadn't expected it to be that big. Oh, I need to go back this way. I don't know of a way to stop that. Oh, I didn't even see him hiding in there. I think I remember killing him before, but I didn't see him that time. I don't know of a way to stop these worm things. I know they eventually wear off. It just takes a long time and makes you use all of your Estus flasks. Great. Oh, wow. Okay. Well, I can upgrade my weapon if I go pick up something. But... there actually might be another Titanite shard somewhere in this area. I'm quite familiar with what's in here, but I will be buffing because I think there's an enemy of some kind. Yes. What's on this corpse? Not worth. It's time for me to go back to the bonfire before I die, because this next bleed damage will kill me. Xbox has a lot of render issues. This is a notched whip, I do believe. Yeah. Nothing too crazy. If only I had a weapon that I upgraded with twinkling. If only. And of course one that I could use. Some interesting drops around here, but that butt. gross. Store a great sword, and then there's like the executioner's great sword over here. Somewhere over here. Where was it? Oh, it's right here. These guys are just weird. And so now... I can't remember if it was this time or the last time that I befriended the giant. I want to hope that I did. I think I did. Oh, well, I can upgrade my Estus Flask again. Poor guy. I want to take her down there. Damn it, bleed damage. Okay, no, I don't think I did friend him. Oh no! She does bleed damage too. Okay. Oh, I wanted to check if I have the stats to use any of those swords I just picked up. No, I don't. It requires a lot of dex and strength. This requires a ton of strength. I could have that relatively soon. Judging by its name, I'd say it's a special weapon, so I should be able to upgrade it with Twinkling. Through here. And we'll keep going. Gotta keep going. Oh no, I need my souls. Is there anything over there? No. I feel like looking around for drops and stuff. Oh! Rusted coins. I will eventually need to do a lot of grinding for equipment. No. Yeah, everything just went wrong there. nothing went well. I hate it when they run at you with their sword up like that. Because I don't understand if there's just a time that they wait to swing. If it's a set time, I don't know. But it's definitely, like, designed to catch somebody who's rolling away. They really like to stack damage types here. Or just in this game in general. Enemies in the swamp, in Farron's Keep, they all did poison damage, plus the water was poison. Then here, everything does bleed damage, with continuous bleed damage effects. Alright, I'm gonna try this run, but this never goes in my favor. All I have to do is make it to the door, and I'm good. Think I'm gonna make it. Yeah, I made it. And then they all kill themselves. Time for shortcut number one. I was expecting one of them to cast a fireball immediately after that one did. I forgot to grab my souls, didn't I? Oh yeah, they would have been in that little shit. A thousand souls is a lot at the beginning. I don't know if I want to go back and get them though. That area, especially, nah, it's just not worth it. It's not worth 8,000 souls. Here we have another run. Nothing more than a run. Come on. Swing. Oh, I thought he was gonna do the swipe. As soon as he does that, I need to be watching. Oh no. Hit the other person for some reason. Well, goodbye. Don't go in that room. Bad room ahead. Very bad room in there. Shortcut number two. Hollowing is at five, so I should be able to go get another level or something. What level am I? 21. Not bad. I guess I'll go ahead and go through this. This is the path to Rosaria's bedchambers. where you join Osiris Fingers, which is a covenant, which is the red covenant for this game. This guy drops a ring. What does that ring do? Oh! Cool! Why is it called Deep Ring? So, up here, go left, dodge his crossbow bolt, or block it. Jump! Don't die. Drop down again, don't die. And then screw your spells. Here's where you get the red soapstone. Right here. This dude, this Brozef, this is the guy. Wait a minute, what? This must be a dude right here. He's always been here for me. It's weird. No, I haven't killed him. Odd. Never even noticed he had a crib over there. Oh, one here too. Oh, well, yep. I'm gonna go ahead and join. Alright, so yeah, you can alter your appearance or reallocate your points from here. I already put up a video about that, so I'm not going to talk about it again. And I'm actually going to use this bonfire because there's not really a shortcut, or there's not any benefit to using this bonfire, but... I'm gonna go ahead because we have this bridge thing that we can use now. And that takes us around the top and down an elevator to the boss fight. Oh, what's this? I don't remember. Nothing. Absolutely nothing. That's the front door to the place. If you want to go back out that way, I could go get my souls, I guess, if I wanted to that way. I didn't want to go down that. Contraption does not move. That's a long drop, too. No way I could live through that. So... damn it. I wonder if I could, I'm gonna try something. It might move too fast, but we're gonna do this. Ooh! Yeah! Pro strats. Go ahead and grab the elevator since I'm gonna be using that bonfire. I'd rather not have to run. Oh shit! Fuck you. Now I can do that. Actually, I think that my strategy might be faster. Nobody with their sign down? Well then. Let's go. Oh, I hit B instead of A because Japanese. Screw you. Just having a good old time. Gotta get rid of these guys so I can kill the Pope guy. Ugh! Actually, that helped me. No! So the fat guys can do emit force or just force or whatever. This is an easy boss if you can keep him from doing that. No, stop! No! All my work! Damn it. Oh no.
Damn it.
Okay. I'm glad that's done. Ah, such a relief to be done with that. Right then. So, the next boss is these Abyss Watchers, or I think they're Abyss Watchers. It's a difficult boss, so I'll have to upgrade my weapon again. Probably have to summon somebody, but I'm expecting there will be summon signs for this, because it's personally one of my favorite bosses to do co-op for. It's a lot of fun, especially if you get a good weapon and just destroy this boss. So we'll pick up here in the next video. I will have to... Oh, yeah. I look at that. I guess correctly, there are some summon signs, not as many as there were on the Japanese version, which is odd because there weren't very many people playing that. So, yeah, I'll upgrade my shit, and then we will fight this boss in the next portion of this. I don't believe I missed anything too major. If I have any trouble with this boss, though, we will definitely go back and we'll fight the Cursed Rotted Greatwood, or whatever that thing is. So yeah, if you enjoyed this, leave a like and subscribe, or come back later and watch. I hope you found it informative, and if there's any specific area guides you want me to do, guys, tell me, because I did the two that gave me the most trouble. So if there's any that give you trouble, I'd love to do it for you. So I'll see you in the next one.